transport you to the hospital.
Anytime a patient experiences a respiratory emergency, you must be able to recognize the condition indicated by the signs and symptoms and act immediately. In this program, you have seen respiratory compromise. You have seen the three kinds of impairment to breathing-related functions and their causes. You have seen abnormal breathing and the signs and symptoms associated with respiratory conditions. You have seen the characteristics associated with adequate and inadequate oxygenation. And you have seen respiratory distress and respiratory failure and how to manage them. Any patient can develop a respiratory emergency with little or no warning. The most important thing you can do is to recognize it as early as possible and provide the necessary emergency care required. Knowing what to look for and how to respond will be crucial in those instances where every second counts.